I'm here to tell you guys about the evolution of music. It's known to be a prehistoric art. It's evolutionized along with us, so as we grow, music grows with us. And it's always going to continue to do this. This is a quote that I read that says, "Music is life. This is why a heart beats." And as everyone here has a heartbeat, and everywhere you go, you listen to music. Whether it's to a cruise, whether you're traveling, anywhere you are, you can have music around you. All right, so I say think of your children, because the music you listen to now will affect your children, just like the music that your parents listened to affected you in some type of way. I listen to all types of music. Originally, I'm Hispanic, so I started out listening to Mexican music, Selena, like banda, reggaeton, all types of stuff. But as I grew older, I started listening to stuff like 50 Cent and, you know, like Little John. So now I'm a little older. When I was in high school, I went to raves. I just went all out. I went to trips without actually leaving Arizona. And now, kind of like 3 years ago, I started listening to rock, and then very recently I started listening to the blues, like Dean Martin, Frank Sinatra, just people like that, you know what I mean? Just new music, open-minded. Oh, and reggae, you gotta listen to Bob Marley, his son, Stephen Marley, just, you gotta keep it Rasta, you know? In the 50s, we need music because it's for the human well-being. People rely on music. When you're sad, you listen to music. You go to it and you rely on it. Mm-hmm. So this is gonna go on to everybody else. Just whatever your mood is, you're gonna listen to music to whatever your mood is. So in the 50s, the beat was generally like more acoustic. This is because we started off with jazz. Like we started off with saxophones and then pianos. And later on in the 50s, we started playing guitars, the bass, and the drums, which later on brought us synthesizers. Synthesizers gave us rock and roll. This is because it gave it a more electronic vibe to your guitars. So this made it less acoustic, and harmonicas were brought along with this, and bongos. In the 90s, we got what is known as auto-tune. This is what ruined music today. So we also got the beat makers, which is an electronic version of basically guitars and drums, as everybody knows. And today we use basically just an upgraded version of what we used in the 90s. Lyrics changed. So in the 1950s, we were passing through the Great Depression, World War II. And African Americans were trying to come out of slavery, or just slavery, we were trying to end it. And in these times, we started vibing to what's known as R&B, which is rhythm and blues. So this is known as an African, this is known as the African music, like, basically, you know what I mean? And I have my little note cards on. In these times, Elvis came out with a song called Hound Dog. I don't know if you guys heard of this song, it's very popular. Mm-hmm. Originally, this was from a lady called Mama something, and she was an African American, but this song didn't become popular because of her race, and Elvis brought it up. In these times, we also had a moment of comfort because everybody was depressed, everybody was sad, trying to stabilize themselves, and this comfort made lyrics more about love and trying to keep your family together. In the 1980s, we had music about women and drugs, basically trying to party. I did a kind of like an experiment with this. 16 out of 30 songs that were made in the 80s were about lust. Like basically just having fun with women or partying. And 26 of those 30s were rhythms to party with. You know what I mean? In the 1990s, we came out with something that was like, they brought cheating to like to the world. And as all those guys know, it's the girls that cheat. That's why she's taking them out. And this was also when we had slower music, because like people were smoking a lot of weed and just, you know, it wasn't that heavy, like heavy metal, because in the 80s, the drug that was around was cocaine. And this hyped everybody up, and in the 90s we were more mellow out because everybody was smoking and relaxing. Oh, I went backwards. And this is just a little example that I have for you guys. In the 50s, this was a popular song. It says, love and marriage, go together like a horse in a carriage. This I tell you, brother, you can have one without the other. And that was a popular song in the 50s. Now we have a 2000 popular song that was by Shaggy. It's called It Wasn't Me. And it goes a little like this. It says, she caught me on the counter, but it wasn't me. She even saw me doing it on the sofa, but it wasn't me. She even caught me in the shower. It wasn't me. She caught me on camera, but it wasn't me. And she stayed till it was over, but it still wasn't me. That's it. That's all, man. Oh,